Okay, clinical depression is a really serious mental disorder. I don't want you guys coming with this thinking I'm making light of it and all. However, there are a lot of difficulties in understanding Beck's theory, but understanding his theory is kind of integral to understanding how this therapy works. And therefore, trying to liven up and explain it in a way we can understand, I'm going to use ponies. My Little Pony, French is Magic, is a show about magical ponies, mostly analogous to human adolescents, which this treatment is designed for. Same principally at young girls, I happen to enjoy it very much. It provides examples of cognitive disorders, externalized attributions, and relational aggression, which are all elements of CBT cognitive theory. Beck's cognitive theory that depression is rooted in negative thoughts about the self, the world, and the future. Self-blaming and internalizing attributions. Everything is my fault. A person suffering from depression will make the assumption that negative events or events perceived as being negative are caused by them, or not being smart enough, good enough, or not liking them. In this film, that show, a pony named Pinkie Pie's friends have been avoiding her to plan a surprise party. We'll see how she reacts to that.
Should be more excited. Excited? Excited? Why would I be excited to attend my own farewell party?
Farewell party?
Yeah! You know what, Tim Morty decided to take me out of the group and throw a great big party to celebrate! A $1 pinkie pie party!
What in the world would you think we didn't like you anymore?
Okay, so as we can see, that is, she thinks her friends are throwing her a surprise party, obviously. But she's so convinced herself in this depressed state that her friends don't like her anymore, they're avoiding her. So she's come up with this idea that it's a go-away party. They're going to throw a party to kick her out, which is, you know, to a normal person or a person not in a depressed state, you know, kind of a nonsense idea. But, you know, when you're in the throes of depression, it actually seems very logical. The self. Relational aggression and depression. This is something I'm particularly interested in, so I had to kind of work it in here. CBT does talk about relational aggression. I didn't fit particularly in this treatment of depression, but it is important. Especially in young girls, blaming self for loss of friends, perceived faux pas, etc. In this clip, Pinkie Pie discusses the importance of being secrets. Notice the finality of her pronouncement, that like if you screw up with a friend once, they won't be your friend ever again. That it would be your fault that you screw up, and you know, these kind of like global attributions, these kind of this finality of things, that like if I do this once, you know, it'll ruin my life, is again very common in depression. The self, the imaginary audience. Particular to adolescent depression, it's not really found as much in other people unless they're intense narcissists, is the effect of a more widespread imaginary audience. Teenagers typically believe they are constantly being watched or judged by others, and to be a rather nasty combination when paired with internalizing attributions and negative self-image. If you don't like yourself very much, it's really easy to imagine no one else likes you. So here we're going to see another pony kind of in that situation.
You don't survive the clip? To be ridiculous, you're only facing a large crowd of ponies who can be watching your every move and silently judging you. You're cute! No more!
So, that was Fluttershy and a very nervous pony, and like many ponies, like teenagers, you know, she thought she was going to be judged, and the pony, its name I forget, I think it's Snapshot or something, a photographer pony, kind of focused in on that and was like, oh, well, they're only going to be judging your every move. Which is not a nice thing to say. The world, cognitive distortions. This is the belief that the world is unfair and it has to do with personalization. It has to do with the attribution of personal responsibility or causal role for for events over which you have no personal control. This clip attributes the weather, events, etc. to small involuntary tics she has. This is actually kind of strange. It has more in common with OCD, but it does show up in depression as well.
What in the wide, wide world of Wester are you two?
Oh, it's my tail! It's my tail! It's a fidget twitching! And you know what that means?
Actually, Pete, I haven't the slightest idea.
The twitching means my pinky sense is telling me that you two better duck for cover!
Oh, Pinky, it's not gonna rain. Weather's barely even out in the...
So, in that case, it's kind of funny. It's more usually things like, thinking, like parents got divorced because of you, or, because your friend snapped at you, you know, you're an idiot. It's not because they were just having a bad day. Finally, jumping to conclusions, kind of leads into two things. It's mind reading, assuming special knowledge of the intentions or thoughts of others, and fortune telling, exaggerating how things will turn out before they happen, which is kind of what the previous clip was about too, and a little bit. In this clip, Pinkie Pie assumes that because a zebra, Zephora, is different, that she is somehow an evil witch. So she thought because, you know, this other zebra, again, you know, she made up all these, you know, extravagant distortions about what this pony was, not this pony, this zebra would do to her because she was somehow different. And again, that's mind reading because it's assuming, like I said before, like, because your friend snapped at you or your friend didn't acknowledge you in the hallway, that means they hate you forever now, which can seem like a reasonable attribution. Finally, the future. The future is hopeless. Thinking that things will never get better, the future is bleak, etc. This one would be very, very difficult to break out of. Just because if you think things will never get better and lose hope, it's really easy to just keep thinking that, and unless like you're provided with hard evidence that, you know, it will get better.
My sisters and I were raised on a rock farm outside of Ponyville. With their big work deal, there was no talking. There was no smiling. There were only rocks. We were in the south field, preparing to run through the rocks to the east field. And all of a sudden...
So that is a happy ending, but the idea there is that she talks about how she never felt joy before, which is really common among people being depressed, saying that they've never really felt happy. Even if like you point to like specific things in the past, like, oh, weren't you happy when you got that toy, or, you know, when you were playing baseball with your friends? Like, well, no, I wasn't, you know, I didn't really feel joy. I might have felt good for a little bit, but then I'm back to being depressed. All right.